Come in to play with mom for the clinic, or did you?
What kind of forge is this? A Coleon. It's kind of cool looking.
It'll be just us.
This is three? Oh, wow. Now we don't need it much higher than that. Fit for some length on it, the width, I guess I should say. But we would definitely want to still cover his heel. So. If that happens, I usually just hold it out like that, so I would still cover the heel, but it'll be able to be fit with quite a bit of width. And doing that, the medial side will end up a little bit longer, so we go ahead and just grind it away. You see it just running that down ever so slightly, kind of grinding more on the medial. And then what this little St. Croix shoe does have is that nice toe. That's a really nice little high shift heel for this horse, where this one does not. So the first thing we're going to do is put this toe in here, and this late breaking quarter in here. Make sense? And then, so I'll just get a nice they shake on it first, and then go to the foot. So the first one, if I did it this way, I know to do this one this way. So I keep my pairs. That's nothing more than just drawing it out just like you would a clip. But it makes a nice base for the heel to sit here, but I can still keep all the width. And I've never really noticed anything from happening from taking it off, taking it away. Do we know what this little modification is for? What's the little...
On those blocks of the rice plate?
Yeah.
Small block of rice.
Yeah.
Okay. Out the front side of it.
I gotcha.
Dropping up the trailers out there underneath the transfer on the back.
Oh, this?
Yeah.
Working
large shoes on the end. Like, where your fingers at?
This?
Yeah.
What? Yeah. Cool. All right. So we got a shoe hot. So first thing we're gonna do is capture that round toe. Now I want to accentuate that and move my quarter down as well. So I'll flip it around like that. Flip it around like that. And now all of a sudden, I have that same shape. So, and this would be a nice shape that I would get his foot. So push that foot around just a little bit more and then head over. And this one is a little further down the net, so go to it. Head straight over. We'll put our lips in the wall. And I kind of see where we are. So we're plenty wide. So this one's like 5 1/4. So we'll close up just a touch. And get ready to level and go burn. Yeah, same thing. So capture the round shape of my toe. Round shape. Point it up. Pull my quarters back. And this one was roughly 5. We can burn on under the tent. Ha! I guess we can do that, right? Hell, it doesn't matter to me. I've smelled it before, once or twice. Oh, yes. What do you think? Let's see what happens. Yeah, what the hell? He can leave. Take the tent with him. Hopefully, he'll turn it wherever it was rented from. Okay. so everybody can see the same shape, right? So the raw toe, the leg quarters. I think as long as you come to it in the ballpark, they're good, right? So now we've got our berm, we can flip it over, kind of see where it is, adjust everything, like see where my nail holes are. And again, it's slightly full at the toe. So my main objective for this one is, I know I'm gonna be in the ballpark, but see if I need to open or close and really make sure my clips are in at the right angle. And I'll admit I struggle with guys like this that are real sloping, real pitched. So when I look at that, I think that's really pitched, but you can look at his clip and run your hand up it, and you've got, it's in the wall, and it like tapers out, right? So I've got to get more on it. Does anybody want to feel that first? Thanks. I mean, it seems like something really simple, but it was like groundbreaking to me that if I couldn't feel the rim all the way around, then the clip's not in the wall. But I used to look at it and go, oh, well, hell, the clip's in the wall, I just need to thin the clip. But it's not simple. So, and I'll admit these little guys give me a hard time making sure I get them pitched enough. So we'll just cut it in ever so slightly. Yeah. Yeah, now, you have carpal tunnel surgery at 25. You learned how to sharpen it? I actually went to go, told me a lot. But I thought I was getting up sharp until someone showed me what sharp is. Burn them in there. So again, that just gets the tip of, honestly, another little cool trick I saw from somebody the other day, that you don't get either your toe clip or whichever clip you're putting in. If you, like, let's say you get pitched over enough to where you see the cut at the top, just lay this little guy on there and burn it, and it'll make yourself a mark. So then when you flip it around, it's in there. If you come to the foot without having it pitched the right amount. Honestly, I'm not sure I brought a fuller with me. So, but either way, I think is good. Whether you fuller out and make that. But I'll admit that right there is a modification I use all the time. And then you'll see when I grind it, I'll almost grind this away. So when they come in and land, it's just a roll. So this is pretty thin. And I've had good luck at getting those lateral heels back in a little better shape. Because I think as they land, that's what helps push them further forward. And then I think that's also some of the part that's hard on them. So sure, standing there, like base narrow and kind of toed out doesn't help the equation, but I think some of it's coming in and landing as well. Oh, you're good. I want to make sure you see. So again, we know we're in the ballpark. I got to get this medial in. See, that's a hard bend, and I might even soften that a little more, as you can see, like the thickness here versus that. So I may soften it a touch more. But like I said, our main objective now is to make sure our toes where we want, and we get our clips. And so this is a good example of one where I didn't get the clip all the way in. So that gives me a good tracing of the lateral one. Nice tracing of the medial one. And then I think it's always cut easier when you're half. So I'll start to cut my clip in that shape. But I think it makes it easier to put them into the
into the wall rather than trying to just go back and forth, back and forth.
But everybody sees how it just makes that impression, and then you kind of have to eyeball the depth and the thickness. But is that anything you can do to get you kind of pre-started? Helps me at least. And then just remember what I need to do to that shoe. So I'd like to take the clips in a little more. I'd like to bring this in. But you can see that's a kind of following along. You know, if anything, still, even though drawing that out, I might still not get all the way to the end of it. But again, on these guys, I don't think that's a huge, huge concern, because you don't really want to get a whole lot of length on them anyway. But this thickness right here, so not that I'm trying to make the foot match the shoe, but you've got it, it's folded over. And it's got this chunk, so if you run your hand over it, I didn't really notice it until I went to burn it off, but we'd love to just soften that ever so slightly and blend it into a nice. And I can try to cut it extra short for Pat. This is a Kirk Hart SX8. Oh, I've got some Liberty Copper nails, my man. I've got a winning sales product. Get melted. I'm glad it stopped raining for this. Be one of the quietest animals I've ever worked on. Yeah. Really? It sounds. Maybe it's just mine. Oh, where's the button? Oh, we lost it. Oh, it's gone. Oh,
shit. It's running downhill. That's a good thing.
Uh-oh, right towards somebody's lunchbox. And my old pile of crap. Facebook Live. Brian, same shit, different day. Come here, little buddy. You can see how I'm like forging out that little pad, it just barely catches the heel. So I think it's worth taking the time to do that. But now you can feel in the clips, and there's a grinder handout, which is really nice. It's a little warm, but you know, my sensitive hands from the glue.
Watch out, bub. Bait. Got you. Coming through.
Got you.
Could I put myself in the best spot?
Oh, now we're getting somewhere.
Let's see.
Ah, damn it, I put it on the wrong side. Oh, I'm going to grind.
Thank you.
Terrible for your Pritchell, but...
Well, no, for man, who wants them shoes?
No,
And so again, I think we could all argue maybe tighter fit through here, but again, that's a pretty sharp in and bend. So I've got a much more gradual one in here. So if, let's say you lay those two curves there, see how much more gentle this is. I just like slow, gentle changes. No, nothing real hard. And then who's got grass? So the last thing, you know, again, I think we all can feel those sharp edges. Again, if a foot can chip and break up on the ground, I think it can chip and break up on a shoe to a certain extent too. So I take it away. Take that little ridge away. And then we'll go fix my other shoe. So my other one, I don't know if anybody saw it, but I tried to bring in a heel and cut across the toe. It's just going to ring. It's going to be impossible to nail. So it's going to go out and then around. So we just have the lateral side hot. And we'll pull it out to go around. So you see around, see out of the out end, so you capture it in the shoe, but I still think it's one of my tougher ones to fit. So if anybody's got any great suggestions on how to my paper. Oh, I'm just trying to get this thing on. One touch over. My snail fish.
You can be close.
Yeah.
I personally have not noticed much of a difference there. They drive good, they clench nice. They look all rough. They don't rust. They what?
What does it taste like?
Copper.
Are you putting them things in your mouth?
So, there we go. Finishing up. Call it a day.
You will not get the same chewing job next time, just so you know.
Not the same one?
Go back to racing plates.
We're ready to see like this little lip of the shoe that's fit out to the toe. I think that's important on these guys that drag.
You say that now after you got it nailed on.
Huh?
You say that's important now after you got it nailed on.
Oh, well, yeah. Well, like I said before, I think. Check Facebook.
See, this is just like I wanted it to look.
Man, hell yeah.
You had a lot of footwork. Super glue, hell, make it look shiny.
Your time shiny.
Yeah. Horse safety 101. Me under a horse, you under a horse.
Just inside help, man.
Yeah, I got help. So you guys put super glue on everything?
No, just when you're.
Just when I'm going to keep the copper on there.
I was going to leave that one and show Travis how terrible it looks.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That is my first glue on.
No, somebody's going to leave one without super glue and one with.
Oh, yeah.
Just to see. I don't know.
Yeah.
I like
just
a
little bit of it.
Yeah, no, that is a good thing. Do it. See.
Yeah.
See, let me know if you see it.
Oh, I'll take a rasp and rough all over it.
Oh, yeah. Of course he would. You can't trust the damn thing.
No, I have found some of those horses that are like stay red all the time.
Yeah.
Like super glue. I don't super glue anything. But like those, I have felt like it's made a difference.
It has.
Because I get, you know, in my line of work, I get a lot of horses getting in the lot. Knee-tucked a lot. Getting a lot. They get fast every single thing.
Yeah. Make one big mistake. One clip's
over. No, I will do it on the horses that I think are getting too much water in me, and I swear I think it makes difference. It's still on there.
You want to get the rest of it?
No, I mean, it's dry. It'll just cut through.
All right.
And you charge more money because it looks pretty.
All right, guys, what do you think?
I'll tell you what. I'll tell you what it looks like in 6 weeks when you got to come back.
And yeah, no, that's the question. I'm curious as to what it will look like.
Tell you what, he pulled it.
It is, but I'll admit, you know, again, I'm just not one of these people. I don't. Maybe I should. Maybe one day it's going to come back to haunt me. But I go by the bottom of the foot. I'll admit, I'm not one to be out here sighting hinds all these different ways. Like I kind of look at them from the front or from the side, and if this is pointing towards their belly, there's a problem. This blood is starting to go this way, it's getting good. If it'll land anywhere between here and there, that's a nice hind. You know, so I just look at them and look from the bottom. I mean, I don't mean to try to oversimplify it, but I like to have, you know, quarters moving somewhat together, not one way up and one behind. So this one has two different feet. Particularly, this left hind has two different quarters, and I try just to start to move them back together. If I really think this quarter is in the wrong spot, I won't fit. If I really think that's not where it should be, I'll fit behind it or in front of wherever I think it should be, and see how the foot responds. If I come back and it overgrew right in that place where I didn't fit it, then that's where the quarter wants to be. And from that point on, that's where I'll put it. If it'll stay there, not blow over it, I'll keep it back where I think it's quarter. Even though I know it's not always the right
Dylan.
Thing. And then on these hind feet, here if it's the lateral heel that's pushed up, I'll grind away this lateral heel, like this part. Because I really, like that, I think sometimes that hard edge, as they come in and land, can start pushing quarters up. And me personally, I think hind quarters are behind the 50-50 ratio. Like I think, you know, hind feet are more, you know, 60-40 or, but does anybody agree, disagree? Or,
what was the statement?
So I think hind quarters are usually much later breaking. I don't think they're like dead center. I don't think I get 50-50. So I go with that. So when they start getting close to 50, I will grind away wherever I think it's going to hit and push it forward, and I won't fit that quarter. I'll put the quarter in my shoe where I think it should be, and then see what happens. If that quarter overgrows my shoe, then I tend to start fitting that. If it doesn't overgrow it, then I start getting back on the quarter that I want. But again, it's me and what I want. It's not necessarily the horses built like. And so if they keep shooting over it, then I fit it. And you can see here, I mean, on this, like this is a great example of, like, I fit to it, but it's not like I'm going to come out here and then over there and get to it. But I think it's quarter's supposed to be here. If I can soften landing here and get it to come back, half the reason I think that is this bulge, you know, kind of rolling under. It's not shooting out. If it's shooting out, I tend to think that's where it's off. But again, it's just me and my my mind, and I got no proof, no scientific evidence, no nothing. But when I'm just messing around with them, yeah, I'm on shoes once a year. Yes, ma'am. I can't. Yeah. Kill him one over the other. Yeah, he's just, yeah. So be it, but that might be part of the reason his lateral heel on the left side would get beat up more so than this one. I mean, you just look at the shape of him, and this is a nicer, happier, fine shape, right? And you saw that went on easy. That's pretty fairly pleasing to the eye. Nothing too worrisome. You know, and then this one's the opposite. It's got the bulge right here. So this comes down and then rolls in. See it? Rolling under. So I fit out two ribs. Okay? But this one's the exact opposite. It rolls under laterally, like this one. So you see how that comes straight out? But this wants to roll under. So I really think hammering that away. And I'll admit, maybe it's right or wrong, but I usually don't worry much about if I get all the way to that. Trim, I just try to knock it flat and get a whole bunch of toe off of it. Try to increase its palmar angle and then get rid of the front shape to it. You know, I mean, it was a real front, so now it's at least got half a hind. This is kind of one of those hinds. But I think part of this is accentuated over because I overburnt that clip and it's over angled. The other three I'm pretty happy with, but this one's a little over angled. And you see what I did to the toe right there. So again, I think you should be critical of every single job you do. And okay. And there's no point standing back and going, woo, gosh, you nailed it today. You know, if you're not hard on yourself, nobody else is going to. You know? So if you want perfection, you need to demand it from yourself. That, you know, it's just flat out overburnt, it's overpitched. And it translates. Is it going to kill the horse? No. Is it really going to cause a problem? No. Am I going to lose a lot of sleep? No. But the very next person is walking into the cross times.
Yeah, surely we got all the viewers. A bit more. So truly we got all the viewers are gone by now.
No, we got good? Some.
All right.
Say hi to our viewers. We've got viewers.
I grind it.
Send that out live on StockX page, on Facebook pages.
There's no reset the shoe behind.
Yeah, most of the time. We're going to make new ones. And again, not that I want to pick on resets, because I do like resets, but I do find myself sometimes, if it's questionable at all, or if I think I messed up, like this horse, there's a mental note. I overburnt the medial clip, and I didn't quite fit the medial toe exactly the way I want it. I'm not going to reset that one next time. I want another shot at making it fit. And then again, if it's a horse that, you know, I'm just doing for the first, second, third, or fourth time, I try, this sounds dumb, but I try not to reset them so I don't make the same mistakes. But, you know, does that make sense? I know it's not the most cost-effective, it's not the most time-saving, but so it's my horse, and I've got it for a long time. I would. I find myself being more honest with myself, you know, if that makes sense. I don't know how everybody else feels about it. Yeah. But it's just me, you know, it's just one of my things. But I mean, I do like to reset. If it's my horse and I get to a point where I don't really have to top dress it, or I don't really have to shape on it very hard, hell yeah, I think that's the time to reset it for forever. But if I find myself, I hate the shape, I'm constantly trying to carve a knife shape it if I'm trying to move things. I find myself, me personally, being more honest with myself if I just make it more. I can get a little lazy. Lazy, they rhyme for a reason. So. Any other questions? We got any Facebook comments? Nobody talks to us? Why?
They're on a delay, so we'll ask if they have questions, and then it'll be quiet, and we'll wrap, and the questions will come in.
Sound Horse Technology Series 1 horse. And they make them in race cars.
Oh, they do?
Yeah, they do. Some also sell them to you.
Pardon me?
Hey. Hey, yeah, 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 I know what you're getting glued on.
Pink glue for me.
Travis, Lydia Mudd says hi.
Who?
Lydia Mudd.
Oh, watch your Facebook. Sit and work.
So you're saying using the super glue helps when they're in a wet, in wet condition?
I have found myself, yes, that I feel like it helps.
Okay. Yeah. It helps the overall condition of the foot.
I just hope it keeps, you know, it keeps some moisture out of the wall. You know, I've seen some improvement. And maybe it's just my horse or my customers or whatever, but I feel like in my practice, yeah, I've seen some improvements.
Right.
I got that.
Are you regular glue on this?